So we're here today with Kevin Scramlin, who is running for Groveland Township Supervisor. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you, Crystal?
I am great. Can you tell us why you've decided to run for Supervisor?
Yeah, I think the biggest thing that has motivated me was probably just the thought of serving the community. I've lived in this community, worked in this community my entire life. Our businesses are here. And to be honest with you, I just want what is best for this community. And I think it's probably a little bit of a time for a change, not only here, but in a lot of other places. My mom was the township treasurer here for 24 years. So when I grew up, I was pretty acknowledged of the township.
Is there anything specific that you think needs to change or that you want to work on?
I mean, there's a lot to be worked on, obviously. I think one thing that I would like to change probably the most, I want to have a real community involvement here. I want to be very accessible to the people. I want them to be involved. I want them to let their thoughts be known. Not that you're going to probably make everyone happy. We all know that's not going to happen. But I think a lot of times with politics, as I watch, I think people look at us and tell us what they think is best for us. And I don't think that's necessarily true. I think we should be involved in all of us trying to figure out what's best for us. In our township, there's a lot of nice things that are going on. We have an ORV park that is supposed to be opening hopefully sometime this year, but with the COVID-19 stuff, we know that's not a given, but it's going to happen at some point. So the development along the Dixie Highway corridor is going to be very important. With that being said, our township does own a fair amount of parcels around that park. And I think for township viability in the long run, it is certainly going to be in our best interest to figure out what to do with those parcels and to get the most out of them for the township and the people of the township. Other than that, our fire department, Groveland, has been very lucky to have a tremendous fire department for decades. In the last few years, there's been talk of trying to combine financially. They've had some problems. They seem to have gotten it straightened out. I think the big thing is, though, is that we need to work with that fire department, keep it viable to serve this township. As far as the services we get for the money that is spent in our township, we don't have a police department. The state police patrol our township. We never will have a police department. It's probably just not feasible for our population. I think our fire department is our pride and joy. I think it needs to be worked with year after year to make sure that keeps going. And the other famous one for every politician is probably the roads. We have a ton of gravel roads in our township. I don't know what the right answer is to get them fixed. I do know we keep doing the same thing years after years, and they're not getting any better. So I really would like to explore maybe some different alternatives to try to improve some of them.
So what are some of the ways that you've been involved in the community?
I mean, my family's been here since 1910. So we have farmed here since 1910. I still farm. So we've got 110 years in the township. We've always been very active in 4-H and the Oakland County Fair. My sons were actually the fifth generation of Scramlins to be in Oakland County 4-H. So our family's very proud of that. We've always been active in Farm Bureau. With that being said, I've been lucky with a couple Farm Bureau trips. I've got to go to Washington, go to the Hill, meet our congressmen, meet our senators. Same with a few days at Lansing. The Farm Bureau has a legislative day every year. So I've got to meet with some of them. So I have a pretty good idea of what's going on. Very active in the Holly Kiwanis. It's a great group. We do Christmas baskets for the needy at the holiday time. And we have a wild game dinner every year. Unfortunately, with COVID, we didn't get to do that this year. But I love that charity because all the money is kept local. You know, between Groveland and obviously Holly, Springfield, it's local people and the money stays local. So I enjoy that. And over the years, Little League, besides playing, coached, we've sponsored teams for years. So our family in general has always been very entrenched in the community.
And what is some of the professional and business experience that you bring to the table?
Well, I've farmed my entire life, so with that, you learn a lot of good things and a lot of bad things. And then my wife, she runs an embroidery business that her and I own. We've been just involved in a lot of different stuff, and sometimes farming's good and sometimes it's bad, but it exposes you to a lot of stuff, anything from public relations to being an accountant to being a dad to being a mechanic, and it all happens in the same half hour sometimes. So you get very adapted being on your feet and being ready to make some things happen.
So in this race, there are a few people running for this position. Why should the voters pick you?
You know, I think the biggest thing for me is, like I say, I keep going back to it. I want the community involvement. I want totally what is best for the people of this township. I have no ulterior motive. I have no self-motivating motor. I just think it's time for a change. And sometimes change is what is needed to make life better. I think we all fight change sometime. I'm probably the worst one to preach about it, but I think for everything in life to keep evolving, we have to keep changing. And I just really want the voters of Groveland Township to know I have nothing but their best interest is why I'm running for this position.
So if the voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
We have a Facebook page. It's Kevin Scramlin for Groveland Supervisor 2020. It's up and running. We've had great response on there, and we're going to keep updating it all the time. We're hoping to have some meet and greets this year. With the COVID stuff, we don't know if that's going to be possible, but you can go on there. My phone number is on there. If you have any questions or would just like to talk to me about things in general, I would be glad to hear from anyone.
Great. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to do the interview today.
Hey, I really appreciate you having me on and giving me a minute to talk to you.